Good afternoon, class. I am Teacher Jesseline Apatas. You can call me Ma'am Jess for short. Before we start our class, can someone lead the prayer?
Thank you.
verb agreement. A subject verb agreement is the grammatical rule that verb in a statement must match the set number, persons, and gender of subject. In English, the verb is to match just the number and sometimes the person. So, we have in subject verb agreement, we have singular subject and plural subject.
About the compound subjects and an example now.
Yeah.
Neither John or Jones. Neither John or Jones run at the marathon.
Neither John and Jones run at the marathon. That's correct, Paul. The third rule. Nobody is a singular form, so we are using the singular verb remembers when they are our subjects. So we will proceed to 6 rule. Sir, do you have an example of the paper?
Everybody enjoys having you in our class.
This noun requires a singular verb. If you are not sure, there are not the word that ends with S, a singular, you can speak it loud, like mathematics. So without S in the end, but if not, it will be a failure to achieve. So if you say mathematics, you can pan up something.
Thank you.
scissors are rusted.
Is it what? Can you stand?
Ma'am, my scissors are rusted.
Oh, Thank you.
Number three, the quality of the candles is or are poor. The quality of the candles.
Wala pa. Out na.
The quality of the candles is or poor. Go.
No.
Speaking grammatically correct.
Thank you.
What I can take away from our lesson today is that English is such an interesting subject, since there are a lot of rules and there are a lot of exceptions. Parang din sa sinabi ninyo kanina, isang rule is a singular subject. Needs a singular verb, while in some cases a plural subject can have a singular verb and vice versa.
Thank you.